According to a new study from scientists at Northwestern University, there is a direct correlation between brain damage and extreme religious fundamentalist beliefs. Now, these scientists looked at MRIs and CAT scans from soldiers returning from Vietnam, CAT scans that they had already had on hand. They looked at the religious beliefs of these people, and they found out that if they had damage to the prefrontal cortex in their brain, they were far more likely to not just be religious, but to be fundamentalists, meaning that they accept the literal word of the Bible, and they believe that everyone else should also do this. So here's basically what this study says. It does not say that everybody who is religious or is a fundamentalist suffers from some kind of brain damage, but they are showing that those who do suffer from brain damage are far more likely to hold those same beliefs. This actually provides us with some pretty good information about how the brains of these religious fundamentalists across the globe actually work. By acknowledging that there is a link between prefrontal cortex damage and religious fundamentalism, perhaps we can treat it. Not saying we need to treat all religious people, but I'm saying that we need to look at this as a possible mental health issue here in the United States. If you want to be religious, that is perfectly fine. That is your right to do so. Imposing it upon others, using it as a tool for discrimination against others, that's where it crosses the line, and that is where we might find some kind of brain damage, believing that you are superior to other people based solely on your religious beliefs. That's what has to stop in this country. It doesn't matter if you're a Christian, if you're Muslim, if you're Jewish, or if you're Hindu. None of that matters. You are free to practice your faith, and nobody has a problem with that, really. But it's when you decide to impose it on someone else or to use it as a tool for discrimination, that's when it becomes a problem. And according to these researchers, if that's what you believe, if that's the kind of person you are, it's actually pretty likely that you may be suffering from some kind of brain trauma. If you're thinking about subscribing to our channel, I strongly encourage you to do that. But if you're not thinking about subscribing, I would encourage you to start thinking about it, and then once you're thinking about it, actually go and do it. You can see the subscribe button right there on the screen, or if you're watching on a different platform, go to youtube.com/theringoffire.